And this video is about calculating frequency using SPSS. So before we proceed with the video, let's understand what do we mean by frequency. In technical term, frequency is the number of times that event is occurring. And in simple terms, it is number of time the variable is repeating itself. For example, you got a variable called gender. This variable gender can take two values, either male or female. So frequency will tell you that how many respondents are male and how many respondents are female. Suppose you have collected data for say 5 different locations, data entry has been done, and then you are interested in knowing how many respondents are from which location. In this kind of scenario, frequency is something which is helpful to you. So let's understand how do we calculate frequency using SPSS. For the simplification purpose, we have our SPSS file ready, which is presented here. Now if you look at this data file, we got various variables. We got variable called ID, gender, B date, EDUC, job cat, salary, cell begin, job time, priv, XP, and minority. Now before we proceed with frequency, let's understand what do we have in this data file. For that, we'll go to variable view. We just expand this label column to make it more visible. So we got variable called ID, which represent employee code. We got variable called gender, which represent gender, and in gender we got two values, F indicating female and I'm indicating male. So gender has two categories, male and female. B date is date of birth. EDUC is education level in years. Job cat indicating employment categories, and we have clerical, custodian, manager, three categories, and zero for missing values. Salary indicate the current salaries. Cell begin indicate the beginning salary. Job time indicate months since hire. Priv XP indicate previous experience, and minority indicates minority classification, which has two value, zero for non-minority, yes for minority, and nine for missing number. So if you look at the data file, we have two kind of variable available here. There are variable which are category variable, and there are variable which are continuous variable. We got one variable, date variable also, but we are not worried about that variable as of now. So if you look at variable called gender, it can take two value, male and female. So it is a category variable with two categories. EDUC, education level, okay, it is a continuous variable. Job cat is a category variable. Employment category, which has three value, clerical, custodial, and manager. Then we have salary, which is the current salary, which is a continuous variable. Similarly, salary beginning, job time, previous experience are a continuous variable. We have variable called minority, which is a category variable with two category, yes or no. Frequency distribution or frequency calculations are more relevant for a category variable. So let's select one variable called gender and see how frequency is calculated. So we'll go to analyze. We have descriptive statistics, and we'll click on frequencies. This kind of dialog box comes in. This is called dialog box because software talks to you. You are given a command, calculate frequency. Now software talks to you in terms of two boxes. On the left hand side box, we got all the variables which we have entered in a data file, and the right side variable is a blank variable. So you have to select a variable for which you want to calculate analysis. Here we'll select gender, and using the arrow key we'll take it to the variable box. It means we are specifying gender as a variable. Now along with the frequency, we are also interested in chart or graphical presentations. So we click on the chart menu. What is available to us is bar chart, pie chart, and histogram. Now for a category variable, most suitable chart is a pie chart, so we'll click on pie chart. We have two options, either chart by values or chart by percentage. So we click on percentage chart. So we want chart by the percentage. Simply pressing continue and pressing OK. Now what we have is, we have a new output file emerging data. This output file has two table and one graphical presentation. Let's start with the table number one. Now what do we have in the table? N indicate the sample size. Valid indicate the valid sample that for which the data has been entered. So 474 is the sample size. It means this file contains data about 474 respondent. Missing 0 indicate that all respondent have answered this question called gender. So gender has no missing values. Second table is a frequency table, which indicate the column like frequency, percent, valid percent and cumulative percentage. Frequency indicate the number of respondent under each category. So indicate that 216 are female and 258 male out of 474 respondent. In terms of percentage, 45.6% are female and 54.4% are male, so total comes to 100%. We got one more column here called valid percentage. Now, to understand that valid percentage column, let's understand how do we calculate percentage. So 45.6 is calculated by dividing 216 divided by 474. Suppose in this data file, we got say 10 missing, it means 10 respondents have not given answer to this question. It means they have not revealed the gender. In that case, the percentage calculation is supposed to be 216 divided by 464 because 10 people have not responded. So that gives you a column called valid percentage. In this case, since there are 0 missing, there is no difference between percent and valid percentage. We got one more column here, cumulative percentage, which indicates cumulative frequency presented in the form of percentage. So female respondents are 45.6. If you add male respondent to this, that is 45.6 plus 54.4, you have 100%. Below the frequency table, you have the pie chart indicating two genders with a different colors, and specification of color in terms of legend is also presented here. This is how you calculate frequencies. Let's try the same exercise using another variable called job cat. So we'll again go to analyze, descriptive statistics and frequency. If you look at this, the last variable is already there. You need to select the variable. Using the arrow key, you can take it back and select the new variable for the analysis. If you look, click on the chart, you will see that earlier last chart selected is already there. So simply need to press OK and you go to an output file indicating the missing value is 0. Among the total respondent 474, 363, that is 76.6% are clerical job, 27, that is 5.7% are doing custodial job, 84, that is 17.7% are doing managerial position. So this is the frequency and percentage. Again in this case, there is no missing value, so percentage and valid percentage both are equal. Let's look at the column called cumulative percentage. So what do we mean by 76.6? 76.6 is the percentage of people doing clerical work. If you add custodial, so clerical and custodial together are 82.3%. If you add manager, so clerical, custodial and manager, all three turns out to be 100%. Below that, again, you have a pie chart where three job categories are presented in different colors and the specifications is given in the legend table. This is how we calculate frequency using SPSS. I hope you have understood. For any query, feel free to give your comment. Thank you.